Trustee Borninski.
Good evening.
Trustee Foster.
Good evening.
Trustee Ganguly.
Good evening.
Supervisor Graham Hudak.
Good evening.
Let the record reflect Clerk Segrist is in attendance. Treasurer Slavens.
Good evening.
Trustee Snyderman.
Hello, everyone.
Supervisor, you have 100% attendance.
Thank you. Can we please all rise for the Pledge of Allegiance?
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I have a motion to adopt the agenda with the addition of our new, let me see, RBA on the consent calendar C2 to consider resolution affirming approval of the Senior Alliance 2022 Annual Implementation Plan for Aging Services.
So moved.
Support.
Clerk Segrist moved, made a motion. Treasurer Slavin supported. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion passes. Can I have a motion to approve? Oh, there's no, let's see. Can we have public comment on agenda items only? Public comment on agenda items only. Anyone here for agenda items only to comment? No? Let's see. Let me look online. I was online. Let me see. Where was it? Look online for public comment. Public comment. I don't see anyone but Patrick Sloan. Patrick, if you want to make a public comment, raise your hand. Okay. No, nobody online and nobody in the room for public comment on agenda items only. All right. Thank you. Next is payment of bills.
Madam Supervisor, I motion that we pay the bills.
Support.
Motion made by Treasurer Slavin, supported by Trustee Snyderman. All those in favor say aye.
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 Motion passes. Next, it is our pleasure to read a resolution.
Amory, do we need to do the minutes?
There aren't any. Yeah, it says no minutes. Yeah. Which is, no, that's okay. That's okay. We're going to give a resolution recognizing Police Canine Hank's retirement. Which one is Hank? Bring him out to the front, please. We're going to read a resolution for Hank. Whereas the Canton Police Department recognizes the importance of its canine unit. Whereas in 2017, Hank started his career in law enforcement with Canton Police Department's canine unit, where he and his partner, Officer Brian Zinzer, were responsible for the tracking and apprehension of suspects, searching for evidence, missing persons, and narcotics and community events. Whereas in 2019, Hank was reassigned to a special task force team with his new partner, Officer Ken Robinson. Whereas during his time in this special unit, Hank assisted with federal, state, and local law enforcement narcotics investigations.
Friends.
Whereas Hank and his respective partners attended weekly training classes and were required to certify biannually with the National Association of Professional Canine Handlers. Whereas Hank retired from his canine unit duties in 2021, but continues to reside with his partner, Officer Robinson. Resolved, the Board of Trustees of the Charter Township of Canton is appreciative of the commitment to excellent service as demonstrated by Canine Hank, Officer Robinson, and Officer Zinzer. Further resolved, the Board of Trustees of the Charter Township of Canton upon does hereby recognize Canine Hank for his commendable contribution to the Canton community and the Canton Police Department.
Support.
Supported by Clerk Segrist. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed, nay. So would you like to talk about the dog a little bit, give up some of the adventures you've been on with him? Great. Congratulations.
Hey.
Do you mind taking a picture with the board and all of Hank's friends here?
Hey, Ann, real quick, if you don't mind. Officer Brian Zinzer is the one that trained him, so I don't know if...
Oh,
Would you like to say a few words?
Please. All right.
Well, thanks for training him.
Trained and worked with him for a few years.
Come on up for a picture, everyone. Yeah, I guess so. Well, actually, might have more room up this way, huh? Let me get the camera out. Come on up, Chad. By the way, we have Treasurer Slavin's brought treats for the dogs. They don't want to stay for the meeting? I don't understand it.
Okay. Over here doesn't give us a break.
Okay. Thank you.
I was going to say, I'm going to make a motion that the chief has to bring dogs to every meeting.
That's right. Thank you. All right, next on the agenda is the consent calendar with the addition of the C2. Did you need a hard copy of the C2?
Got it. I'll do it. Madam Supervisor, I move that the board approve the consent calendar as presented. Item C1, consider authorization of a purchase order to Fishbeck Incorporated for professional engineering services for the 2023 Road Improvement Program, Sheldon Road. And item C2, consider resolution affirming approval of the Senior Alliance 2022 Annual Implementation Plan for Aging Services.
Support. Motion made by Clerk Seeger, supported by Trustee Berninski. All those in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed, nay. Motion passes. Now onto the general calendar. Item G1, consider approval of Greenland and Saj Site Plan Grocery Store Bakery.
Madam Supervisor, it is my distinct honor to begin to move that the board approve the following resolution. Approval of the site plan for Greenland and Saj. Whereas project sponsor has requested site plan approval for a Greenland and Saj grocery store and bakery use on the subject tax parcel located at the southwest corner of Cherry Hill and Denton Roads. And whereas Planning Commission reviewed site plan application and applicable criteria, voted 5-0 to recommend approval with conditions as the application meets the requirements of the zoning ordinance. Now therefore be it resolved that the Board of Trustees of the Charter Township of Canton, Michigan is hereby approved site plan for Greenland Massage on the subject tax parcel at 49491 Cherry Hill Road, subject to all state, county, and township requirements, and subject to the following items to be addressed and corrected by the applicant. One, modifying the lighting specifications on sheet L201 to be consistent with sheet ASP1-1, and to comply with sections 2.13 of the zoning ordinance. Two, placing a limestone or similar looking material cap on the compactor enclosure to provide a finished appearance in accordance with section 2.14 of the zoning ordinance. Three, revising sheets A-01 and A-03 to replace the spandrel glass on the north side of the building adjacent to the seating area and drinking edge of the bakery with transparent glass. And four, adding a bicycle rack adjacent to the building.
Support.
Motion made by Clerk Segrist, supported by Treasurer Slavens. The applicant proposes to build a grocery store and bakery on a 1.59 acre parcel located at the southwest corner of the intersection of Cherry Hill Road and Denton Road. The building is proposed to be 19,044 square feet on the ground floor with a partial second floor mezzanine area. There are two entrances proposed, one entrance from Market Square Drive to the west and one entrance from Denton Road to the east. The entrance from Market Square Drive will align with Lantern Way, and there's no proposed extension of Market Square Drive. The entrance from Denton Road is located on the south side of the site and is designed to be as far away from the intersection of Cherry Hill Road as possible. The site is located in the Village Core area of the Cherry Hill Village Overlay District, and the underlying zoning district is RA, Rural Agricultural. Section 6.09b2 of the zoning ordinance states that the Cherry Hill Village design guidelines are the applicable development standards, which are made part of the zoning ordinance. Although the original agreement for Cherry Hill Village expired in 2014, the site is still subject to the standards of the Cherry Hill Village Overlay District in Section 6.09 of the zoning ordinance. The Cherry Hill Village Overlay District requires all projects to be treated as a planned development. At its meeting on March 22, 2022, the Township Board approved the planned development for Greenland and Sage. The Planning Commission recommended approval of the Greenland and Sage site plan at its meeting on July 11, 2022, subject to conditions. If the site plan is approved, the next step will be for the applicant to submit plans to the Engineering Services Division and Building and Inspection Services Division for review prior to construction. Director Jade, would you like to add to that?
Not much to add other than Patrick's on the line if there are any questions regarding it from a planning standpoint, and we're excited to have this as part of the village.
Thank you. We also have the applicants. Would you like to say anything?
Good evening. My name is Najem Samoa with CDPA Architects. We have been working on this project for almost 16 months now. We're excited we are at this stage. Unfortunately, the developers who happen to be the owners also are out of town tonight and they couldn't be here. What I would like to say that this business is not a speculative type of a business. The developers are have established businesses in other locations. So we hope that this will contribute to the Cherry Hill Village and will be a prominent part of it. So I thank you for your time. And we would like to break grounds as soon as we can. I have actually spoken with the building official today. And I understand there are what's called a development start permits, and I mean, it's details that we will go with through with the engineering and building in an effort to get this project started this year yet. So besides that, if you have any question, I'll be very happy to answer.
Thank you. Summer, anything from the Planning Commission?
Nothing to add, no.
Okay, thank you. Any questions from the board? Tanya, any questions? Or anyone this side? Stephen?
Not really a question. I'm excited for it. It looks like great drawings that I saw. It looks very modern, and but still in the tradition of Cherry Hill Village with the brick and everything like that. Jade, the only, and I don't know if Patrick has this, is I didn't see any minutes from the Planning Commission included in the packet, and I don't know if they had any discussion. Won't keep me from voting tonight, but it would be good to see them afterwards. So.
Yeah, I don't know if the minutes have actually been completed yet. So that's
because it was recent?
Packet.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right, that would be helpful.
But I can forward those on to you once they
are. Yeah, please. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Patrick online, I'm sorry. He actually had raised his hand. Patrick, did you want to say something?
Oh, sure, thank you. I can answer that. The Jade is correct. The draft minutes of the Planning Commission meeting had not yet been finalized when this request for board action went to the Township Board. The only change from the Planning Commission meeting was the inclusion of an additional condition to have a bike rack adjacent to the building. The other ones were consistent with the staff report to the Planning Commission that evening.
Yes, Diane.
I just wanted to make a quick comment. I think it's great. We're real excited to see another bakery and grocery store, especially in the Cherry Hill Village area. So we've been waiting for a long time. I know a lot of folks, and so this is very exciting.
Good. If any, I mean, not relevant to this, but we are also working with the developer or one of the developers on another project also in the Cherry Hill Village, right across from the theater. So we look forward to also seeing your approval on that at some point. Yeah, thank you.
I will be voting in favor of this tonight. I'm very excited about the project itself. I think this will be a nice bookend for the village. It will be a draw to the village. When the initial preliminary site plan was considered by the zoning or by the Planning Commission, and there was a local article written about it, I had a number of community members send me the article with their excitement about this coming in into the village. So it's consistent with the plan. It's consistent with what the feel of the village is, consistent with what we're trying to do inside the village, and I'm very excited that the developers are also the business owners. That is, I think, a unique thing and a special thing, and so I'm very excited about this. And I did have an opportunity to talk to one of the individuals involved, and to talk about other developments as well. So I think we're excited about this project. I was excited when I saw it first come forward, and I'm excited today when I see what kind of the renderings kind of look like of what it might look like. So, and again, I would also echo that, you know, I would like this to be open as soon as possible as well.
Anyone else?
Thank you.
Oh, we're very excited about this, and we look forward to seeing everything start to happen, break ground very soon. Thank you. All those in favor of the motion say aye.
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 Opposed, nay. Motion passes. Thank you.
Thank you for your time.
Next item on the agenda is consider first reading of an ordinance to amend Chapter 74, Article 2, Division 3, Subdivision 3, Section 74-133, Building Sewers and Connections.
Madam Supervisor, I move to introduce and hold a first reading of an amendment to Chapter 74, Article 2, Division 3, Subdivision 3, Section 74-133, entitled Building Sewers and Connections.
Motion made by Clerk Seeger, supported by Treasurer Slavens. Canton Township Ordinance Section 74-133, titled Building and Sewers Connections, currently outlines a process for repairs to water and sewer leads in public rights of way, easements, and private property. This ordinance also directs the Public Works Division to maintain a written policy on repairs to private sewer leads and cost sharing with the private building owner. To further describe ownership and maintenance of private sewer and water leads, Canton Township Ordinance Section 7438, titled Water and Sewer Lead Ownership, specifies specifically that water and sewer leads shall be defined as a privately owned service connection from the public water main or sewer main to the building. Additionally, Section 7438 states that ownership and maintenance responsibility for the private water or sewer lead shall remain with the building owner from the point of connection at the public main to the building. The proposed change to Section 74133 removes the potential for inconsistency between Section 74133 and 7438. Furthermore, the proposed changes to Section 74133 promotes and codifies effective public works policy and practices by assigning responsibility for maintaining and operating private sewer leads to the appropriate entity. The Public Works Division will also amend their current policy to reflect the changes in the Section 74133. Director Smith, do you have anything to add?
Just to give a little background on this. This was brought to our attention earlier this year in January when there was actually an incident where we went out and the resident actually turned in their reimbursement paperwork for this. I've never heard of this before. This has been an ordinance that's been on the books for decades, and it's not common practice, nor is it common for municipalities to share costs on private property. So this is just changing the ordinance to come up to speed with what actually should be happening.
Questions from the board? Tanya? No? All those in favor of the motion say aye.
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 Opposed, nay. Motion passes. Item G3, consider approving a request to purchase a 3-year warranty and software renewal for Faro Technologies 3D laser scanner system.
Madam Supervisor, I move to approve the purchase of the 3-year warranty and software for Faro Technologies 3D laser scanner system in the amount of $13,970.
Support.
Motion made by Clerk Seeger, supported by Trustee Brudinski. The Police Department is requesting to purchase a 3-year warranty and software renewal for its Faro Technologies 3D laser scanner system in the amount of $13,970. This purchase will extend the warranty through June 30th, 2025. Director Bao, do you have anything to add?
Well, it just helps maintain the product that was approved by this board. For instance, we used this real recently on crash investigations where there were deaths, and also the murder on Haggerty Road.
Any questions from the board? All those in favor of the motion say aye.
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 Opposed, nay. Motion passes. Item G4, consider waiving the bidding process and approve the purchase of 5 Motorola 800 megahertz portable radios.
Madam Supervisor, I move to waive the bidding process and approve the purchase of 5 Motorola portable radios from Motorola Solutions Incorporated in the amount of $24,918.25 utilizing budgeted E911 funds.
Support. Motion made by Clerk Seeger, supported by Treasurer Slavens. The Police Department is requesting to purchase 5 Motorola APX 6000 portable police radios from Motorola in the amount of $24,918.25. Due to the necessity of continuity in radio equipment, purchasing the same radio as currently owned is imperative. Therefore, the department requests to waive the bidding process and purchase the above model radios from Motorola Solutions, a sole source vendor. Director Bao, do you want to add anything to that?
I do not.
Questions from the board? All those in favor of the motion say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed, nay. Motion passes. Item G5. Consider approving the Merit Commission recommendations for position reclassifications in finance, municipal services, and ITI.
Madam Supervisor, I move to approve the Merit Commission recommendation to reclassify the position of financial analyst, grade 7, to the position of grants, CDBG, and procurement supervisor, grade 8, retroactive to July 13, 2022.
Support.
Made by Clerk Seeger, supported by Trustee Snyderman. The Supervisor's Office is requesting the Board of Trustees approve 3 reclassifications. The first is from the Finance Department, the position of Finance Analyst Grade 7 being retitled and reclassified to Grants, CDBG, and Procurement Supervisor Grade 8. The second is from the Municipal Services Department, the position of DDA Coordinator Communications Specialist Grade 5 being retitled and reclassified to Downtown and Community Development Coordinator Communications Specialist to Grade 6. Lastly, from the ITI department, the technical support specialist 1 position being reclassified from grade 4 to grade 5. The Merit Commission approved new job descriptions on June 30th, 2022, and the reclassifications on July 20th, 2022. If approved, the reclassifications would be retroactive to July 13th, 2022. Deputy Supervisor, do you want to add anything?
Just that these reclassification requests arose from a process that we established earlier this year within the supervisor's office in the township to have representatives from each township department review requests from individual departments for job reclassifications. And so a committee was put together of manager-level employees from each department. And the committee looked at the requests to have these specific positions reclassified and unanimously agreed that based on the responsibilities that these individuals were performing for Canton Township, that these jobs should be reclassified and upgraded to what's being recommended here tonight. So,
questions from the board?
I just wanted to go over the budget impact real quick so that residents are aware. It looks like for this year that all the budget impact is nothing because it's being absorbed by the respective department budgets. Is that correct?
I believe that is correct. But I also believe that Finance Director Wendy Trumbull is also on the Zoom, so she may be able to answer specific questions on budgetary impact. But yes, my understanding is that all of these upgrades are going to be absorbed in the current department budgets this year.
Okay, and then the information in the packet does show some budget impacts for 2023, which, if my addition is correct, it looks like it's about $11,600.
So. Wendy, do you want to comment on that?
Sure. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah. The 23 budget will need to have some slight amendments to them for the departments, I would imagine. Each of the departments should be looking at their own. For example, the one in the finance department will need to be adjusted before we formally adopt the 23 budget. But for the current year, all of the departments took a look at the reclassifications and determined that they could be absorbed within their existing budget structure.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Any other questions? All those in favor of the motion say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed, nay. Motion passes.
Madam Supervisor, I move to approve the Merit Commission recommendation to reclassify the position of DDA Coordinator Communication Specialist Grade 5 to the position of Downtown and Community Development Coordinator Communication Specialist Grade 6, retroactive to July 13th, 2022.
Support.
Motion made by Clerk Seegers, supported by Treasurer Slavens. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed, nay. Motion passes.
Madam Supervisor, I move to approve the Merit Commission recommendation to reclassify the Technical Support Specialist 1 position from grade 4 to grade 5, retroactive to July 13th, 2022.
Support. Motion made by Clerk Seegers, supported by Treasurer Slavens. All in favor say aye.
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 Opposed, nay. Motion passes.
I'm ready to move on.
Thank you. Item G6, consider authorization of a 2-year lease agreement with Dance and Feet at the Summit on the Park.
Madam Supervisor, I move to authorize the Township Supervisor, yourself, to sign the 2-year lease agreement with Dance and Feet at Summit on the Park.
Support.
Made by Clerk Seegers, supported by Trustee Snyderman. Canton Leisure Services and Dance and Feet have had a mutually beneficial partnership over the years. Therefore, we are recommending a 2-year lease agreement with Dance and Feet with 3 automatic 1-year contract extensions, provided the tenant is not in breach of the contract. Director Hohenberger, do you want to add to that?
Sure. You able to hear me?
Yes.
Okay, great. Yep, this just renewal, we'll get them back in line with where they were financially pre-COVID, and extends their current agreement, and we're happy to renew with them as partners in the summit.
Thank you. Any questions from the board? All those in favor of the motion say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. Last item on the agenda, item G7, consider approval to increase current and future payments to the program registration software provider Civic Plus LLC.
Madam Supervisor, I move to authorize payment of the current invoice to Civic Plus LLC, P.O. Box 1572, Manhattan, Kansas 66505, in the amount of $34,000, as well as future Civic Rec annual service invoices through December 31, 2024.
Support.
Made by Clerk Seeger, supported by Trustee Snyderman. Leisure Services currently holds a contract with Civic Rec, a software component of Civic Plus LLC, for the program registration software. Per the contract, Leisure Services would like to continue with the auto renewal of the software. When originally approved by the Township Board on December 12, 2017, the fee was $30,000. However, based on rising costs related to volume and software, the current invoice is for $34,000. The current contract states that Civic Rec can increase the fees based on the previous year's activity. During the past year, the Summit on the Park and Recreation Divisions have both seen an increase in participation and usage. No budget adjustment is necessary for the current year. Leisure Services is recommending to accept the current invoice of $34,000 as well as any future invoices through the remaining contract period of December 31st, 2024. Director Holmberger, do you want to comment?
Sure. We did review this increase with ITI director to be sure that he was comfortable with this increase. And this is the first increase that we've seen since we started with Civic Rec in 2017. So not surprising that we would see one at this point. Kind of surprising that we haven't seen one up until this point.
All right. Any questions by the board? Kate?
I just wanted to note, it looks like the contract is up in 2024, is that correct?
Yes.
So I believe at some point we've had some talks in the technology committee about integrating all of our software so we don't have different systems for different departments for payments and things like that. So just hoping that, you know, when this contract is up, we'll be trying to do that to make it easier for residents.
Greg, you spoke to Victor about this. What was his comments? I don't think Victor's on.
No, he's not. Yeah, we spoke with him in regards to just the fee and working with him to ensure that he was comfortable with everything. But when it comes time to review the software, and I know this is on his list of the, I think 151 different software applications that the township has. So looking to consolidate. This is on the same platform. Civic Rec is on the same platform as Civic Plus that our website is on. So it is somewhat integrated. So that makes it a little bit easier for the residents to transfer between the website and any online services through Leisure Services. So we'll work with our ITI department on any future applications. And we can opt out every year on this contract as well, with 60 days notice at the end of every year.
Okay, thank you.
Just, you know, to that point, the clerk's office, as we begin to migrate to a new ERP solution and we integrate, because that process has started now, we are looking at demos, and Victor and the entire team is really working hard. The clerk's office will need a licensing software, and we will be examining Civic Gov with other departments. And Victor, because he is amazing, has said, okay, so if we're using Civic Plus for the website and for forms, if we're using Civic Rec for Leisure Services, and we do have two or three other departments that could benefit from Civic Gov, instead of kind of buying it a la carte, we may want to roll into a Civic Optimize package, and that might save the township money. So he is aggressively looking at that while we look at a new ERP solution as well. and you know, they looked at like BSNA. There's a couple of other people. So that we're going to be doing demos. And so Victor seemed very comfortable with kind of the timeline and how this fed into it, at least at the meeting I was at. And so, yeah. Good question, though.
That's a very, excuse me, good question. Yeah, because Victor has been looking at all of the different.
And I'm not saying that that Civic Rec isn't the right one necessarily. I just want to make sure that, you know, looking into the future, that we are continuing to plan for the for this.
I know when they switched over years ago, I was told, we weren't here at the time, but when they went, I believe, to Tyler, maybe, it took a few years to implement it. So this is going to be a big, heavy lift, but eventually we'll get to where we want to be.
Right.
So.
Mm-hmm. Else? Tanya.
Yeah, I just wanted to add to what Kate said. I had the same concern, like when we did the, I think, strategy or session or study session about how we are incorporating softwares and how we are bringing everything together. So I think you guys have answered my question.
Victor is the ITI director. All the software changes or any computer purchaser go through him so that he makes sure that everything is working together, the pieces. Okay. Anything else? All right, all those in favor of the motion say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. Motion passes. Next item on the agenda is public comment. No one is in the room for public comment. Let me check online. We also have zero attendees online for public comment. So how about board comment? Let's start with Tanya.
I really don't have anything. I just enjoy the rest of your summer. August is coming. Summer is ending very soon. And we have Thursday concerts in the park. So go out and enjoy them. And I think we have next week is National Night Out, right?
August 4th.
Going to unfortunately miss that, but I think people have a great time during that event.
So.
I don't have anything to add, but yeah, like Trustee Ganguly said, enjoy the rest of your summer. It's going by really quickly.
No. Michael, Jerry?
I wanted to acknowledge Leisure Services, and I hadn't thought about doing it earlier, but sometimes when we talk about the Welcoming Community Board goal, we think about like really, really big events, but one kind of smaller event where I saw us put some work in was the Tuesdays Are Terrific concert. We partnered with the library, I believe a week and a half ago, and we had, or 2 weeks ago, and we had an Anishinaabe native program around, there was some dancing and some cultural education around the native tribes that live in Michigan, the Three Fires Council, and the work that they did. And it was really cool. It was really cool to see. And I thought, oh, wow, I went because I have kids, and Tuesdays Are Terrific is a fantastic, you know, and it was great to just kind of walk out because I work here at the township, so I could walk out into the Heritage Park and sit on a blanket and have lunch with my family and enjoy a really cool educational, cultural program that I imagined maybe most of us didn't really even know that it had happened, and I thought this would be important thing to kind of acknowledge at the board level. So I appreciate that Leisure Services is putting in that work and that we're partnering with the library and that we're furthering a board goal. And I just wanted to bring that up here. On top of that, the election, the August primary will be next week. Will be next week. And just make sure that you deliver those ballots by 8 o'clock on election night if you've got an absentee ballot. We have to receive it by 8 o'clock in order for it to count. And that's it.
Thank you. Treasurer Slavens?
No, just everybody enjoy the rest of their summer and all of the great programs that the township has to offer. So that's all what I have to say today. Oh, and congratulations to Tanya. She had a wonderful anniversary on Saturday, 25
years. Quarter of a century,
Congratulations.
Trustee Snyderman?
I am enjoying summer well, and I'm glad to see progress more on our roads. Things are moving along, and they're looking good, and I haven't heard of many problems that people have had in terms of being able to find their way around the construction. I think we're learning to live with it because we all know how important it is.
Thank you, Trustee Korninski.
Just, everybody enjoy what's left of summer. I saw the National Weather Service had posted something today about how we have already come to the average peak highs for summer, and so from here it's all supposed to be downhill, I guess. I'm not sure that's going to actually happen for us, but I'm glad the last few days have been a little bit cooler.
Does any staff members want to say anything or online chat? Or?
I want to say, you know, for the board, we had a nice, very good CCIC meeting today. A lot of good comments about our relationship with Jack and Jill and the school board and the Pride Outside event and some of the upcoming events that we've been working on at the police department. So that was a very good meeting, and we've made a lot of progress here recently with the Wayne County Prosecutor's Office moving away from the fax machine. So we're pretty,
yes, congratulations.
We're pretty excited about that.
That's groundbreaking.
So, that's it.
Anyone online? Wendy, Greg, or Joe, did you want to say anything?
I'm not going to do the no comment. just that I thought we had a very nice event right before the board meeting tonight, celebrating the kickoff of the Sidewalk Get program, which this board made as a priority and has really been prepped. And a lot of work has been put into the plan to fill in sidewalk gaps throughout Canton Township by the Municipal Services Department, particularly Director Smith, Deputy Director David Norwood, and Bill Surchak. And so that was a nice event to be where a sidewalk ends in Canton, but hopefully in the near future where a sidewalk will not end but will be built. And it was nice to have some of the partners in the state legislature who have helped secure some funding for the Sidewalk Gap program there at that event as well. So.
Right, good point. State Rep Ranjit Puri and State Senator Dana Polhanke were there to help us. They were able to secure funding for us, $750,000 for sidewalk gaps, and then we're going to see $5 million more towards roads. So the governor signed that package. I know. So when Canton Center Road is ready to be opened, we're going to have a big event and have our representatives there and Warren Evans, executive. So we're going to have Wayne County there, the state reps, and us. It's going to be fun. Looking forward to that. So I just want to let everybody know last week what we went from. So we had an Eid celebration, and then that went to, this is on top of all of our camps. Then we went to Thursday night concert, LGBTQ plus outing. Then we also had the Michigan Shakespeare Festival, if nobody knew that. That was really big for us to represent Shakespeare Festival. Then we had the Rally on the Ridge. So big last week and camps all week, and now we're moving into the Punjabi Mela is going to be happening on Saturday. So if anybody wants to come to Heritage Park tomorrow, there's some great events. There's a big wrestling event. It's really fascinating to watch if you've never seen it before, so please come. It's a lot of fun. All right, great. Next item on the agenda is adjourn. Can I have a motion to adjourn?
So moved.
Support.
Motion made by Clerk Segrist and supported by Treasurer Slavens and Trustee Foster. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Meeting adjourned. Have a great night.